Good morning, students. As we have discussed in last class about the mouth as a part of the digestive system. As we know, our digestive system consists of two parts, alimentary canal and digestive glands. We have discussed about the mouth part. Mouth part contain the teeth, saliva and tongue. Today we are discussing about the esophagus. The other name of the esophagus is the food pipe. As the main name indicates, the pipe which starts from the mouth and end up to the stomach. This pipe run through the thoracic cavity. Thoracic cavity is that cavity that contain the lungs and heart part. Now the next question is, where is this located? It is actually located behind the windpipe. As we know, in our thoracic cavity there are two pipes. One is the windpipe and the scientific name is the trachea. And the behind the windpipe there is a other pipe that is known as the food pipe, and the other scientific name is the esophagus. And this is trachea, the windpipe that is responsible for the respiration. It has an door over it that prevent the entry of the food from the windpipe to the from the food pipe to the windpipe. That's why we are not advised to talk when we are eating food, because the food can enter to the windpipe, but as the food has to enter to the food pipe. Okay, so food pipe is actually, its length is 30 centimeter long. It has the powerful muscles that help in the pushing of the food from the mouth to the stomach, and the muscles movement is known as the peristaltic movement. Actually, these muscles are C-shaped muscles. They actually contract and relax in a rhythmic fashion to facilitate the forward movement of the food. This movement happens in other part of alimentary canal as well and is called as peristaltic movement. Very, very important question is, there is no digestion take place in the food pipe. It just provide a pathway from the mouth to the stomach. This is all about the food pipe. The other name of the food pipe is the esophagus. It acts as a connecting link between the mouth and the stomach. If we remove the food pipe from our body, then the mouth will food will not be able to pass from the mouth to the stomach, and no digestion of the food will take place. Okay, the next part of the alimentary canal or the digestive tract is the stomach. Stomach is actually a muscular organ, means it is made up of muscle. What is the shape of the stomach? It is a J shape, having a bag like structure. It is the widest part of the alimentary canal. What is the function? It receives the food at one end of from the food pipe and open into the small intestine from the other end. Food is only temporarily stored in the stomach. Here in the stomach part, mechanical and chemical digestion take place. Mechanical digestion means food is broken down mechanically into smaller parts by contraction of muscles, and the chemical digestion means stomach secrete the enzymes for the chemical digestion of the proteins. So the digestion of protein take place in the stomach. Now the question is, how stomach works? How the digestion take place? Actually, food is churned, means food is mixed in the stomach for 3 hours time, means for the digestion and the mixing of the food take place 3 hours. Or 1 hour is having how many minutes? 60 minutes. So 3 hours is having 180 minutes. During this time means during 3 hours time, food break down into the still smaller pieces and make a semi-solid paste that is known as chyme. That is known as chyme. And what about the inner lining of the stomach? Inner lining of stomach secrete the gastric juice. Gastric juice means the juice that contains three things. One is the mucus, second is the hydrochloric acid, and third one is the digestive juice. What contain stomach? One is the mucus, second is the hydrochloric acid, and third one is the digestive juice. Each is having different function, and all these three are very important for the digestion of the food. Without one component, the digestion of food will not take place, because they act or they work in a combinative manner. First is the mucus. Mucus is actually a liquid-like substance that protects the inner lining of the stomach from its own secretions of hydrochloric acid. Because as we know, in our stomach, an acid is produced, that is the hydrochloric acid. If this acid is produced in large amount, then our stomach wall will become destroyed. Then we will get the problem of ulcer. When we get this problem, when we eat large amount of the oily food for a longer time, then the acid production will take place in larger amount daily in our stomach, and this will affect our digestion process, and this will affect the walls of the stomach. And if walls of the stomach will become wounded, and this problem is known as the ulcer problem. So we should avoid, or we should eat the oily food in a proper amount. Second one is the hydrochloric acid. As the name indicates, the acid produced in our stomach. What is the function of this acid? The function of the acid is, number one, it kills any bacteria which may enter the stomach with the food. Suppose we are eating any food from the roadside or any the unhygienic condition, then this food can contain the bacteria. So this acid help in killing the bacteria that are present in the food. So protect our stomach from these bacteria. Second function of the hydrochloric acid, it make the stomach medium acidic. Means the release of the acid is very necessary for the action of the digestive juice that help in the digestion of protein in the stomach. Digestion of the protein means, suppose we are eating pulses or we are taking milk daily. This milk pulses contain the protein, and their digestion should be on daily basis. Otherwise, it will create the problem. Third one is the digestive juice. Digestive juice is secreted by the stomach lining that break down the protein present in our food into the simple substance. And this all happen in the acidic medium, which is created by the hydrochloric acid. Okay, so the partial digestion food take place in our stomach. The partially digested food then goes into the small intestine. As we know, in a 24-hour period, 2 to 3 liter of gastric juice are produced daily, but should be in the adequate amount, otherwise it will create the problem. So what we have discussed today about the food pipe and the stomach, these are two important components of the alimentary canal. Okay, thank you students. If you have any problem, then call me or message me. Thank you.